All right, welcome back to Fuck It Socks, the podcast, episode 57. Today on the show, a white girl dropped the N-bomb after too many Four Locos at the University of Kentucky. We'll give you an interesting take there. Progressives are pretending crime's down in this week's urban decay. The Democrats did a great job collecting all the ballots they needed to stifle a red wave this week. And stay till the end for our uplifting gold section where we're going to try and feel something again. All this and more, it's Fuck It Socks, the podcast, episode 57, ranked the best new podcast of all time.
Because words are just words until action actually starts. And actions speak louder than words. But at the same time, words speak louder than actions because sometimes it's the right thing to do.
Very cool. Very cool.
Fuck It Socks, the podcast, featuring Richard Bradford. That was a great intro. One for one of the intro, as always. Before we get into housekeeping, guys, this week's episode is brought to you by our friends over at UnderTech. Guys, everyone wears underwear. Why buy it from people that hate your guts and don't share your America First values? GetUnderTech.com is the website. This stuff is fantastic. It's made from high-quality materials. It doesn't pill. It doesn't smell. It's antimicrobial. Special Forces wears this stuff, and they love it. And also, UnderTech donates a portion of their profits to stop human trafficking, which is very based. We love UnderTech. It's the only underwear we wear here on the show, and it's for good reason. It's high-quality stuff, and they support us. Holidays are coming. Get some underwear for people that you love in your life. Use code FLECKIS20 for 20% off. GetUnderTech.com is the website. FLECKIS20 for 20% off site-wide. It goes a long way. Support the people supporting us. Full 360 win. Everyone's happy. Use code FLECKIS20. And if you send me a screenshot of a receipt from UnderTech for over $40, I will send you a free base mug. Do that today. GetUnderTech.com is the website. FLECKIS20 is the code. Thank you, UnderTech, for sponsoring. We love you. All right. Housekeeping. Thank you to UnderTech for sponsoring another week. We love UnderTech. Links in the description for that. Let's get into some good housekeeping. We have a very important housekeeping this week. It's one of the most important ones we've ever done. I know I'm saying that a lot, but the stakes keep getting higher. So here we are. The thing causing heart problems and blood clots this week, one alcoholic drink a day.
Just one drink a day significantly raises risk of stroke among young adults.
Interesting.
Young adults, too. Specific. They're getting specific.
Well, they're going to need answers. And remember, they used to always say, like, oh, a drink a day is actually good for you. Like, doctors recommend it.
Just one glass of wine.
Yeah, wine, a glass of wine a day keeps the doctors away. I think they did that basically to prime everybody. So now they can use that excuse. So like they say a glass of wine a day is good for you. And then now everyone pretends, oh, that's what everyone did. And now people are going to get blood clots and heart problems at young ages. And they're going to be like, well, everyone was drinking that glass of wine a day.
Yeah. So some of you were drinking eight a day. Some of you wine moms voting Democrat were drinking eight a day.
So they definitely primed us for that one. Unrelated, here's a graph of miscarriages and stillbirths by year. Now, I can't see it because it's behind us, but does it look bad?
I don't know. It seems like a spike.
Does it go like this and then like this?
Seems like what the kids call a straight line up.
Yeah, that's a hockey stick graph. And no, it's not a shit coin.
It's not the price of wheat. Yeah. It's stillbirths and miscarriages.
Which is very sad. I wonder what's causing that.
Yeah. Don't forget how many people told you, it'll protect your baby, too.
Yeah, pass it on to the baby, as if that's good advice.
I actually, I couldn't find the asset for this, but I wanted to bring this up. I was listening. I saw, like, a video on my feed that was basically, like, a conference call, a third quarter conference call for the largest funeral director in the world. And they were like, our bookings are just up. Like, they call them bookings or something, and it's, like, literally people dying. And their third quarter revenue year over year was up 15%. Wow. And usually they expect it to be like 1%. So
something must have happened. All right. On a lighter note, we don't want to get bogged down and depressed. We have a huge announcement, maybe the biggest news since that time I had Diet Cokes with Trump.
Oh, okay.
Richard Rapoy and I got mini bikes.
Yeah.
It's an absolute must have. We got two mini bikes, a red one and a blue one. I don't know what they're called. They're just this little piece of shit mini bikes.
We're calling them hogs.
We're calling them hogs.
They're kind of like off-road mini bikes. It's supposed to be for like probably a teenager who wants to do motocross or something eventually. Yeah. But we're just going to whip around with them and, you know.
Ignore the weight limit. And we're going to be whipping around town. cruising around the Bywater, cranking our hogs.
That was cranking our hogs. That was a big selling point of whether or not to make the jump. A lot of these bikes had a weight limit of 240. Mm. And I'm not going to say who here is above 240, but it's me. And then there's another person who's really above 240. But it worked out. We have ridden one of them. Yeah. We got one.
Because it says the weight limit, and then it also says made in China. And then you go to the guy, and you're like, I'm all good for this, right? And he's like, yeah.
Yeah, you're good. Drive it off.
A little more air in the tire, and we'll send you on your way. And literally, that's what happened. We bought it, and then we just like drove it out of the store into the city with no helmet. And I don't know what the rules are exactly.
Which, I mean, this is what we've been talking about, right? Yeah. Like taking advantage of the lawlessness, like cops, if they even answer your call in New Orleans, they're going to go to the murder first. They're going to go to the shooting first.
Hopefully.
They're not coming for the motorbike boys.
And if they ever do come for us, we're going to split up, and then they'll come for one of us. And then we don't rat.
Yeah, we don't rat. We go off like Paul Walker and Vin Diesel at the end of,
so whoever they catch, just yeah. like,
goes down with the ship.
So obviously this picture of Pavarotti on a Vespa was a huge inspiration for this purchase. You see that picture, Rap Boy?
Yeah.
He's fatter than me, right?
Yeah, I think so.
And he's Pavarotti.
Yeah.
So I got some room.
He's fatter than you, and he's definitely sloppier than you too. Like
he can't throw a football.
No. That's one of the bad things. One of the worst things you can get is that I call it the Peabody, mm-hmm. where it's like your appendages are like, you're really fat, but your appendages are skinny, like skinny arms, skinny legs. And it's like, ooh, you're just a, like someone could roll you down a hill.
Yeah. The guy from Monsters, Inc.
Pretty much. Yeah.
Well, so that's not me. We all agree on that. Mm-hmm. But you know,
it's close.
Pavarotti on the Vespa, Pavarotti, Roddy, Rottweiler, Pavel, dog, Jerry, the dog, Rottweiler.
Pavlov's dog.
That's like a sound purchase.
Yeah.
Universally checks out.
The schizo connections they're everywhere.
Yeah. So we're very happy about that. Obviously, when it comes to having mini bikes, it's very important to next step after that, think about
what?
Mini bike outfits.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah. I wanted to get cowboy boots and ride yeah. around in the mini bikes on cowboy boots. Fleckus was against it for some reason.
We already did the cowboy thing like last year for the Morgan Wallen Christmas special where we mm-hmm. got the cowboy blowout suits and we, you know, got drunk and blew out the
blew
cowboy suits.
Blew them out.
Threw them away after.
Yeah.
And we have cowboy boots. So I'm kind of like, I'm off of cowboy. I want to do something different.
For sure.
So I'm going to be just, you know, murdered out wearing whatever. I'm not really, but you need to look a certain way when you are driving the mini bike. We obviously are larger people. The bikes are mini bikes, large mini.
Clown. It could get clowny real quick. It
could get you. I could be Jadavy on clowny pretty fast. To avoid that, we're going to need to narrow and box ourselves out outfit wise. So I am thinking a shirt with like an
open shirt.
Yeah, kind of like what you got going on.
Kind of flaps in the breeze type.
So from the back, I'm a boxy guy. From the front, I'm waving in the wind. Where does his body start? Where does it end?
Is that Pavarotti?
You know? So that's what we're up to. We're very excited about it. We'll be cruising around the Bywater, hitting all our spots in our cool new mini bikes.
Yeah.
Best purchase of the year. Feels good.
And also, I told Fleckus, I said, because we filmed that Morgan Wallen Christmas special. Mm-hmm. I said we should film a mini bike Christmas special yeah. where we go around town and do stuff. So stay tuned for that.
Yeah, definitely stay tuned for that. We do have some Jerry updates. Jerry the dog. I got Jerry a hoodie, which was pretty cool. We put it on him. He liked it. He kind of felt like he was one of the boys.
Yeah. he liked it.
He liked it. We all had hoodies. And he's like, all right, this is like a rite of passage or something. And then for the next day I woke up, I came downstairs. And Jerry was sleeping on the couch for the first time ever. He's not allowed on the couch. He's never been on the couch. He never even tried to go on the couch. And for the first time ever, he was sleeping on the couch. So I think he thinks he's like one of us now.
Yeah, he took the liberty. He's like, what? I'm suited up?
Yeah.
I'm one of the boys now.
That's where they all chill. So I had to cut it off him with scissors. It actually was a
passing over that. It was a little tight.
So it was a little tight.
We reordered a double XL hoodie.
Yeah. I didn't trust him to like, he might like dislocate his own shoulder or
not
something.
Not get strangled. Anything.
So I just cut it out of him. But that was great. I've also been trying to teach Jerry tomorrow,
which is a tall ask. That is a tall order.
It's impossible. He does not understand it. Here's a little clip of me at the dog park trying to teach him about tomorrow.
Hey, tomorrow. Okay. We'll get that tomorrow.
So, yeah, it's just not going to happen, I don't think. I'm trying to get him to know tomorrow. So when he gets high energy at night and he's jumping around, I'm going to be like, yo, tomorrow we'll go to the dog park. And then he hears dog park, and then he gets crazier.
Yeah.
So that's doesn't right. realize that tomorrow cancels out now.
Yeah. So, which I don't think he's going to get there. He's not going to be able to remove himself and conceptualize days of week.
So. Well, we can hope. Another Jerry update. And this one actually might get cut because depending on how everyone reacts, it might be kind of embarrassing. I don't wash the dog.
Interesting.
I don't wash the dog.
You don't bathe him. He just kind of runs around in dirt and then like he resets every day or what?
He kind of, I think it's like a self-contained thing. Like he's not dirty. Even when he gets mud on him, it eventually comes off or it brushes off.
Okay.
You ever see a wolf take a shower?
No. You ever see a lion stretch before hunting a gazelle? No.
Exactly. Yeah, so
I'm with you on that.
Or keep it in. It's not that bad. But yeah, I don't really wash the dog. Someone asked me about that and I was like, yeah, I don't wash the dog. You're supposed to wash the dog? Yeah. It kind of seems stupid.
Every once in a while. He's not really a stinky boy.
He's not stinky.
No. But you know, you should do it every once in a while, right?
Yeah. So I don't wash the dog and I'm basically under the impression that the chew toys can be eaten all the way because he just keeps eating them. And then they wouldn't make it out of like a poisonous material if it was bad for dogs.
For sure.
So
you're safe.
We're all good. The dog does what he wants. He doesn't shower and
He wears a hoodie. He's on the couch. He's got a motorcycle now. He's living a weird life.
Yeah.
A lot of changes since last week.
This whole like, I live like in an apartment. It's like a loft apartment. The loft has gotten interesting. Now we have Rottweiler, the motorcycle, guns.
Yeah,
it's becoming like this weird place where we got a lot of man stuff going on.
Yeah,
man stuff. We work out a lot of stuff like that. Let's see. I also need to find Jerry a place for Christmas.
Mm.
So I have to kind of find someone who's trustworthy, who's not going to secretly abuse the dog because my political views, or also
imagine someone finding out. I found his Instagram profile. I have a trans cousin.
That's what I'm saying.
And they start just hitting Jerry.
Being so mean to him, farting in his face, stuff like that.
You do that.
It's not true.
You do
that. That's disgusting, too. So that's not even true, but we need to make sure people don't do stuff like that because that wouldn't be cool.
For sure.
To have it continue to happen to him even when he leaves for Christmas. Okay. We're still in housekeeping. It's a very important housekeeping. And this one is actually, we have a couple of lessons. This last page is a couple of lessons I learned this week. It's nothing too crazy. I think people will appreciate the advice. Guys, if you follow the recipe, you'll get penne alla vodka. I used to think I can kind of make it myself. Oh, I don't have a white onion. I'll get a yellow onion instead. Oh, I don't have heavy cream. Let's do half and half instead. Oh, no need to add vodka. I don't feel like showing my ID to the guy who brings the groceries. You have to stop that mindset and just do the recipe and get the stuff. It's called penne alla vodka. It needs vodka.
Yeah.
And if you follow the recipe and do it like they say, you'll get penne alla vodka.
No half measures. No, you need to be fully in, committed.
Just do it. Just do the recipe. And I literally did it, and I cook myself by, like, taste. And I don't fully know what I'm doing. So I'm always, like, adding this, adding that, overwhelming it with this, trying to neutralize it with that. And this time I just followed the recipe and it tastes like penne alla vodka you get at a restaurant.
Yeah, I tasted it as well. I was a witness to this and it was very good.
Some of my best work, people are saying.
Yeah.
Also, second thing I learned when driving with Richard Rapboy, if you're driving and people are getting off the road and there's traffic and they're trying to merge like out of an exit lane and they're like in traffic and like just trying to sneak in and you're trying to do the same thing, go in front of a person who's trying to sneak in. So once they sneak in, you're in front of them, and karmically, they basically have to let you in.
Yeah, because they did the exact same move. They got over late. Now they have to pay it forward.
So if you're trying to sneak in, get in front of the guy who just snuck in, and he'll let you in because who's he to turn you away?
And
we did that.
We successfully tested it and did that. So that is a verifiable thing.
Yes, exactly. Last piece of housekeeping, I actually made a new sick rap lyric, but it does have the N-word in it. So when the N-word comes up, I'm just going to go,
Okay.
You know?
That's
just
fair.
Kinda, that, which is fair.
So you couldn't come up with a replacement word or something?
It just flows too good.
Okay.
And this rap is about a person.
And you're planning on selling this to a rapper, right? This
is kind like of a ghostwriter.
Okay, for sure.
That was always my dream before politics. So this rap is about a person who's like an OG in the game, okay?
Okay.
So it's, I run these streets for years with my set. Cross me, I'll put you down, dog. I'm the vet. I'm the vet, like veteran, like the dog. I'm like a veteran, but also like the
veterinarian.
Dog. Veterinarian. I'm the vet.
All right.
Thought that was pretty good. That takes us out of housekeeping and into a very important election section. So my current view on the election, this is Friday, the week of the election. My current view is Republicans won every race, and anything less than that is voter fraud.
Okay. Okay.
Which I think is a pretty safe take. And it also takes the section of the show onto a satirical timeline.
Yes.
Where basically everything in this section is basically satire.
Covered by satire and parody laws, and YouTube cannot do anything. I agree with you, because there's no way the Republicans could have won every race.
Which is exactly.
AOC's district, you know, Chuck Schumer type shit.
Smart, right?
Yeah.
But yeah, everyone's trying to figure out what happened. Everyone's like, what happened? We had a red wave. What happened? Guys, the Democrats collected all the ballots again.
They have a machine. They have machines humming in every key state to make sure that ballots get brought to someone who's at their house, like an old lady, and they go, here, just, oh, well, we can fill it out for you. Well, actually, I probably shouldn't say that.
Yeah, but they really do the process very well. It's a game, and they've gamed it, and they figured it out. Republicans win based on energy. Republicans win for the economy. Republicans win when the drag queen's trying to fuck the kids.
Yep.
Republicans win with COVID and lockdown. So ideas-wise, Republicans win. And then Democrats kind of just count on their like retard base to show up and vote because they want to murder the babies. Mm-hmm. And then they also just get some like a little bit. And then they just collect all the ballots they need after that. They just focus on the game of collecting ballots.
Yes.
So and we're
a ballot is different than a vote, right?
You know? Yeah, exactly.
Like
exactly.
A vote is some guy who stands in line and goes, I'm voting today. A ballot is like a piece of paper that touched a voter's hands maybe for a brief second and then got run through the machine.
Exactly. So the Republicans, they're great with getting votes. Like, oh man, like I'm from New York. And I'm in Florida now. I am going to go vote for Ron DeSantis, and I don't want them teaching the kids the gay stuff, and I want to not be locked down and ruin my business. Like, you get that engaged person, that voter, to go pull the lever for you. Like, that's great. That's what Republicans did well based on like what's going on in society these days. Democrats just focused on collecting all the papers.
Pieces of paper. Yeah, it's individual pieces. It's nice thick cardstock, so it's not just any paper.
Especially in cities, too. Which is basically what happens, right? Like Lee Zeldin won 49
counties
and Kathy Hochul won 13.
13, yep.
But you know, the ones she won are the cities. So basically the cities are where Democrats handed all their ballots. And at the end, they squeeze the city and they ring them all back and they just put them in for the Democrats.
Yeah. Yeah.
And
for sure.
So it's like there's like a system that's not really in our favor and everyone's like trying to win based on ideas, which is great. But ballot harvesting and all these things are legal in most states. And that's what Democrats do very well. It's not legal in Florida. And you kind of see what happened in Florida.
Yeah, exactly. I was going to say that's the control for the non-ballot harvesting. And
And that's why Beto lose because Texas is the biggest cities aren't that big, but give Texas some time to get more people. And then those cities will turn bluer and bluer. And then the whole state turns purple and then blue.
For sure. Beto will be running for like Intergalactic Federation chairman soon.
Yeah.
He's run for everything. Senate president and now governor. And it's three straight L's. Stacey Abrams took an L as well.
Yeah. So it's good to see, you know, the L's get taken.
It's good to see like that the thesis panned out in some ways and in some places. Right.
Yeah.
And I hate Stacey Abrams. I always said, cause there's a certain level when you're paying attention to politics, you start to see who's being super propped up and like who's being pushed on you. And, you know, like for Republicans, like not everybody lives in Arizona, but Carrie Lake was one that was like kind of presented a lot, got a lot of good social media just for like the way she kind of did things. And Stacey Abrams was that Democrat version. Beto, obviously, as well. Stacey Abrams, the difference between how much she was propped up by the media and like Democrat machine and whatever versus how much she's actually ever done might be the biggest spread I've ever seen. You know, they try to make her seem like an accomplished woman or something. And it's like, she's done nothing other than whine about voter fraud in Georgia and run for office for herself multiple times.
Exactly.
So that was a good one for me. That was a pleasurable one.
They really, exactly. They try to make it seem like she's a passable candidate, knowing that they have the game down of collecting all the ballots.
Yes.
But they still couldn't pull it off, which is nice. And the Democrats are kind of just gangster for that. That's just gangster shit. Red wave, everyone has the energy. Like, it doesn't feel like the red wave feeling wasn't, you can't do any better than that.
Yeah.
Everyone's going to go. It should be every race. We got this. And then, no, They collected the ballots
We got the paper. And then it's like a combination of that plus like a lot of angry millennial girls who are furious about abortion and really, really want to be able to kill their unborn childs that they won't.
It's so important to kill the unborn babies. And it's like every single thing went towards Republican. Married men, married women, and then everything went Republican except for single women.
Unmarried women went Democrat to the moon.
Because they need to kill the baby so they can work at Amazon for $12 an hour or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, I don't know what they're doing. Or just work an email job at Meta before you get laid off. That single unmarried woman thing, overlay that graph of voting for Democrat with the usage of SSRIs, antidepressant medications, starts to paint a pretty grim picture there, right?
It does.
Like, they love abortion. They're on antidepressants. They're voting for Joe Biden.
They want the kids to go down dark roads. They just hate children.
Yeah.
They hate children.
So that's greasy. Yeah.
Other election news, Pennsylvania elected John Fetterman and a dead guy. Yeah. Millions of votes for these two. John Fetterman, to be honest, now that the election's over, we can kind of put politics aside.
Yes.
We went a little hard on him. To be honest, John Fetterman is a brilliant man.
Yeah.
The guy is a savant.
He's an operator. He just knows how to campaign. He knows how to get it done.
He simplified it, the language.
He
too.
Really did, yeah. And it kind of a Trumpian-esque.
Yeah. You know how Trump is like super simple and the everyday guy can understand him? That's how John Fetterman is. The Eagles are better than the Eagles. The Eagles are 8-0.
I know.
The Eagles are the best. He's right. I know.
He's right. And now that he won, he is right. That is confirmed. The Eagles are better than the Eagles.
Yeah. He ran on Roe v. Wade and against Roe v. Wade. Genius. That's both sides. That's why he got all the votes. People from either side of the argument would vote for him.
Yeah. What else was he proven right on? Yeah, you need to have a computer screen to be an effective senator. I think he's proven right on that.
Good
you need
night,
audio.
Everybody.
Yeah, good night. Good night is now an intro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So there's that.
Do you want to talk about Oz at all and how he sucked and how we wanted Kathy Barnett and how he was a bad candidate?
Well, Oz was always a bad candidate to start, for sure. We were never a fan of him. We were a fan of Kathy Barnett. But, you know, it's Pennsylvania is really a place where they do the ballot collecting.
Yeah.
They have it perfectly figured out.
They got good in 2020. Let's just say they got good. Yeah.
So like Republicans want to win. It's like anything within 5 points is basically like the game has it won for the Democrats. So the Republicans to get to really win would have to win by like 20 points.
DeSantis level stuff.
Yeah. And or if you have voter harvesting and ballot harvesting making it that illegal, then you have like the DeSantis type responses. What I didn't like about the election, which bothers me every year, everyone calls it.
They call it so early.
71% of the votes are in. We'll call it. I'm calling it. Why don't you just count all the votes and let me know who's up by what?
Yeah.
And you don't need to call it.
The weird thing is it's like 1% reporting, 1% reporting, call it. It's like, are you guys kidding? I don't even get it. I don't even understand.
Why are we in a rush?
Yeah.
Call it. Why don't we just add them all up and then go, oh, Kathy Hochul won.
Yeah.
Crime's not a problem. We collected all the votes from New York City. So that's it. That's our election take. The Democrats did a great job of collecting all the ballots they needed to stifle a red wave. The red wave kind of still happened, but not fully.
Slim majorities, maybe in the Senate. We don't know yet.
Yeah. So congrats to the Democrats and then reverse congrats to the Republicans who don't do anything. Why aren't we doing our own ballot harvesting if it's legal?
Yeah.
The Democrats are out there doing it, collecting. And why don't we have our own collectors? Oh, we don't do that. We just try to win on the issues. It's like meant to go that way.
Yeah.
So when we lose, we go, oh, we lose. How? We have all the issues won. Blah, blah, blah. We get so mad at each other. When it's really like, why aren't we collecting every ballot we can from Palm Beach Retirement Home? Legally.
Yeah.
Or maybe not Palm Beach because it's illegal in Florida.
For
you
sure.
You know what I mean.
I know what you're saying. They're willing to do a lot.
Yeah. And so it's a frustrating thing to keep paying attention to. Mm-hmm. But that's why on the show, it's just one section. And we're actually out of it, the election section.
Yeah,
that's our thesis.
Exactly. If you want to get, if you want to know what happened in this county and why it trended that way, go listen to, Charlie Kirk,
yep.
Or go find Brett Baer or somebody like
Bannon, War Room.
Yeah,
Charlie Kirk. All those people are covering it. We're not going to get into the weeds too much because we can't. Because we're into Cringe of the Week.
Yeah.
I almost said Urban Decay. All right, Cringe of the Week. Our first clip of Cringe of the Week. is this girl from Kentucky who got super blacked out and said the N-word and assaulted some people on her campus. We're going to give you guys an interesting take here.
And she was arrested after this, too. I think she hit someone as well.
Yeah. So she's dropping the N-bomb. She's kind of swinging at her. Yeah, there you go. Those are some swings, punches. So you're in trouble for that.
Yes.
So like that right there.
Should I skip forward to the...
Yeah, keep going. I think we basically see it though. She's just blacked out. Everyone's trying to wrestle her down. She's saying N-word to the black people.
Yeah.
And she's swinging a little bit and pushing. So first things first. If you assaulted somebody, you're in trouble for that.
Yeah, you shouldn't be hitting people.
As you should. That's the rule always. The N-word stuff, I get people are upset to hear that. That's not great.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's a bad look, for
it's
sure.
It's not a good look. It's not good behavior. But is this the racism boogeyman that we've been told so much about? Is this drunk girl who took an Adderall and drank 2-4 Locos? Is this who is the big bad systemic racism that's keeping black people down?
I think so. I think that's the face of racism right there. 21-year-old college girl got a little too drunk.
Yeah, exactly. So it's we're not saying this is obviously good behavior by any means, but if your proof of racism is the blacked out University of Kentucky girl, George Floyd, and us pretending to not notice who's pushing people on the subway tracks... I don't think you have a very strong case. I don't think this person's keeping anyone down. I think this person's literally blacked out on their worst night and is probably horrified upon waking up. And it's the worst night of her life. She's a drunk idiot.
Oh, that wake up. Imagine that wake up. Oh my God. Being told and then shown the video, which you didn't even know was recorded because you were blacked out.
And it's like, oh, what did I say in the video?
What did
I
say? Ugh. Oh, you said it. You said it every 3 seconds.
And it's oh, to who? Just to you, right? It's no.
You said everybody in the hall.
All the black girls in the hall. Once you say, but the thing I'm noticing, which I think is a problem, is once you say the N-word and you're not a black person, it gets spiraled into this big worst thing. So it's is this what's keeping everyone down? And I've noticed this, which I think is the overarching bigger problem here, is when a person like this white girl from Kentucky, this sorority girl from Kentucky, says the N-word, now it puts the black victim mindset students...
refreshed.
It gets them going and mad. And it's now they have these sit-ins and these protests and they're not going to go to class all week.
Until she's gone.
Yeah. And they're not going to go to class all week. And they're going to kind of pretend racism is the part of all of our problems. And here's the racism that we're seeing. And it's they're going against the man, it's a protest. They're going against the man. And it's when nothing really happened, her saying it, it's not great. It's not good behavior. I don't recommend it, obviously. But did anything really happen? I've heard black people say the N-word all the time. I've seen Hispanic people say the N-word all the time. I've even seen some freak white trash people pull it off somehow.
Yeah, they somehow get the pass.
Where they kind of say it with confidence and everyone's oh, he's just a little different.
Wasn't that whole thing too, with that rapper 6ix9ine? Mm-hmm. He's just a Puerto Rican guy. And he just goes, he's hammering that button.
Yeah.
So I guess some rules, it's just it's a black and white issue, but there's a lot of gray area, I guess.
Yeah, exactly.
And I'm looking at this article right now and they write it out. Like you're saying, with a not playing victim, because obviously something happened, but making it more extreme. With tears in her eyes, the college freshman had a message during a rally Monday night. This is a recurring issue across American school systems, no matter what age. Yeah. So it's like a rally, a whole thing, because a blacked out, brain dead John Fetterman level functions just started saying the N-word.
Yeah. But now that this happened, it's a weapon. Anyone who says it, who's not allowed, it's a religious thing almost, where it's a weapon now, where everyone's now against it. And, this is obviously coming from someone who would never say the N-word outside of his house. I only really use it when making jokes with my friends, my very close friends, everyone else.
What?
It's not a big deal. I'm just kidding.
Hold on. Can I say something too? Good bit, buddy. You got me there. The quote from this girl who was involved or whatever, "I was physically, verbally, and racially assaulted." What does that mean? There's only physical and verbal. There's no racial assault.
Yeah. It's like, don't take it personally. She's the drunkest, stupidest person ever.
Yeah. There's racially motivated assault. You could have maybe said that. Racially assaulted, I think you just made something up.
Yeah, exactly. So the behavior is bad, but it's nothing more than a stupid girl on her worst, stupidest drunk night. I wouldn't look too far into it and try and make it into sort of some systemic thing.
We'll check in on that girl in like a year.
Yeah.
I kind of want to see what happens.
We're not going to send her a base mug or anything like that.
Yeah.
She probably doesn't even like us. She's probably pro-abortion.
I know. She probably just made a mistake and like was like, what can I say to these people to make them really mad? And
doesn't even know what she said.
Yeah.
All right. We're still on cringe of the week. The next part of cringe of the week is cringing from injuries. We adjusted cringe of the week a little bit this week. It's not going to be the same freak woke leftist. It's going to be some, but the first one, guy blows out his teeth trying to jump across the gap.
Yeah, more than his teeth, probably.
So this guy's going for it. He never had it. I think he's jumping uphill and across, too.
1, 2, 3, go.
1, 2, 3, go. Don't listen to him, buddy. Never had a chance. Dead. Now your buddy's jumping in the canal to pull you out. You're done. Go hope. Do you collect your teeth in a situation like that to put them back in, or you just get new ones?
Just get new ones. Yeah. You're not collecting those from the bottom of the canal. And that's the thing. It's like when the guy's kind of like second guessing, he's thinking about it. But once he hears 1, 2, 3, all of a sudden you got to go.
That's like a thing. Same with like working out too. It's like whenever a spotter on like bench says 1, 2, and it's like, I'll do the countdown. Like it's me doing it. So once you get someone else counting you down on something you shouldn't be doing,
you've already lost the plot. It's not yours anymore.
Exactly. Something's up.
If you see the camera out when you're attempting to cross, people are rooting for you.
Exactly. Next, there was a broken ankle graveyard at some football game. Who won the what?
This is bad. Apparently, Coastal Carolina beat Appalachian State. Appalachian. Okay. And they were storming the field, and this is where the video starts. So two people are down. It's a large brick like thing. And then look at this kid.
So everyone's rushing the field and people are in the background just going down after. And there's multiple people down with like blown out compound fracture backwards ankles.
And this heavy kid has
never had a chance.
It's literally like tib fib snapped, twisted the wrong way. Like you thought you were having a fun time. Now you're in the ER.
Exactly. Go ahead.
I saw the article and I think there were 5 people injured, 3 people brought to the hospital.
Broken ankle graveyard.
Yeah.
I was going to put those in uplifting gold and then I thought there's nothing uplifting about this.
Yeah. Up airlifted to the hospital maybe. And you need to stop. We need a good uplifting gold this week. So
this week's uplifting gold is as good as it gets, and I'm not just saying that. Okay. Remember last week, or maybe 2 weeks ago, I did that thing with you where it's like take one of these beans or one of these pills or whatever. And like one of them would be,
you have to wear double ankle boots for the rest of your life or something.
And if people ask you why, you have to say, I think it's cool.
Yeah.
I got like an ad on my Instagram showing off a page and check it out. This guy is wearing double ankle boots fashionably.
By choice, fashionably.
Wow. So
it's like 3 different angles of the double ankle boots.
You could have pulled it off.
Yeah.
And made it some sort of like modern moon man.
If only I knew about this before, that would have been the pill I chose.
Easy one.
Instead, put, what did I choose? 75 pounds? Gain 75 pounds instantly?
Yeah.
I'll wear the walking boots now. Taking that back.
All right. Next clip. The climate change girl.
Yep.
Another person making excuses.
Hello. My name is Louise. I'm 24 years old. And I'm here. I'm here because I don't have a future.
She's a 10, but she's mad because she thinks the world's going to end.
She's a 10, but Greta Thunberg really got to her.
Yeah, her brain's been poisoned. I was thinking, like, what if everyone's getting prepped with climate change and it's really because Revelations is going to happen and God's going to destroy the earth? And then they're doing climate change. So when people see like, oh, there's like this fiery hell pit over here, like this is climate change. So till the very end, people will reject God when they see the world turning into fire.
Maybe. That's a good maybe.
That's a good
maybe. I'm not going to say no.
Thank you.
Yeah, but this is another example. I think we were talking about this with the Alex Stein girl, the spit in the face.
Oh, yeah.
This is a girl who could have a lovely life. Man, she's 24.
Very good looking.
She's attractive, and she's just spending her time. You know, you could build a family. You could be the mom who has 5 kids, and then you're the grandma who has 60.
Yeah.
And you're so proud and you just wake up every day and you get stories and baseball games and this and that. Nah, dude, just go act on a bridge about climate change.
Go stand on the road.
Yeah, you see those tears?
Yeah.
It's like there's an alternate reality out there for you guys. You don't have to be angry. And I like to say this because we have kind of like a fun take. You know, people always say like, well, you guys don't get down. It's like we're laughing at it. Mm-hmm. We're making it bits. And so that girl is not laughing about it. She's not doing bits. She's not having a fun time. It's just misery and acting and a weird combination of factors leading to a non-traditional life.
And right? The progressives need that. They need those outraged people. And then they use those outraged people as like useful idiots, they're called. And then they just justify overreach and taking away your rights and funneling money and raising your taxes just because, oh, everyone's so mad. Climate change is so real. Look how, I mean, they're gluing themselves to Van Gogh. Like, yeah. Of course it's something. You don't probably know much about it, but let's just stop farming and give us 50% tax rate and we'll make the planet less hot.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
China will keep doing whatever the hell they want. Coal powered, whatever. But
then like these girls, it's like, she's not paying a lot of taxes. She has no real job. So yeah. It's like, she just like, is like, oh, like the rich and the elite, they need to do their fair share and we need to make a change. But like, I don't know, I haven't ever accomplished anything or I'm not significant, but you need to stop it so the world doesn't end. That's the dynamic they've created.
Yeah. And then these types listen to Taylor Swift, who's off on her private jet 40 times a month or something.
Repeats it.
So
exactly. Next, the hippo bidet.
Yeah, this one is cringe, I guess.
This could have been uplifting. It's not cringe. He wipes his own ass with the piss. Isn't that crazy? Oh, climate change, right?
Yeah. I don't know. What are you talking about?
Oh, man.
What are you talking about?
Next clip.
You want to see another young corrupted woman with
Joe Biden?
Yeah.
Joe Biden fan with the bra?
Yeah.
0.1.
I don't even like Joe Biden that much. Oh, nice. Okay, that's all I had to say.
You want him to run for re-election, Joe Biden?
I guess so. I mean, I feel like all presidents kind of can't really do good, like that good things, but also like I'm not educated enough on the topic. I just really love fashion and boobies and Joe Biden related merchandise and attention. And I love taking my clothes
honest.
Off. So that's all I had to say.
Yeah, that's it. She likes taking her clothes off. She likes attention. She doesn't know much about the issues, but thinks Joe Biden is the guy. And just like another way of saying your brain's been fried by birth control and TikTok.
Birth control, TikTok, and then peer pressure from the angry climate girl earlier.
Yeah.
Like peer pressure from those types who are informed, quote unquote.
Yeah. So but, the birth control fries the brain. That's what the attention. Same with TikTok going viral. It's all like, yeah, my dopamine got kind of hijacked by the deep state and
China's algorithm.
I'm just doing what I think is best. I'm kind of just a victim to my own desires.
Hey, a woman in politics and it ends with her pulling her tits out.
Yeah.
I don't know. Is that a microcosm of anything? Maybe.
Yeah. Last one.
I don't really know what I mean by that. But,
I think you mean something.
Okay.
Last clip. Gender teacher with the nails.
Yeah, more traditional cringe of the week here.
Yeah, we have to have one.
We could just ignore my hair, please. So today during class, one of my classes were just all over the place. They would not stop talking and they always know how to get me. Ask me questions about sex ed and I'm sucked into your loophole. I don't even know if that's the right phrase.
Loophole.
But
you don't even
one
know. You're the teacher,
like,
you don't know
do
loophole.
Do you believe that there's multiple genders like in this country? And I said, yeah, I mean, depending on where you live, there could be no genders or there could be more than three, depending on your culture and your society. In our society, I do believe that there are multiple genders. And he was like, I don't believe that because when you're born, they assign you boy or girl. And I said, yes, they do, based on your biological sex. Gender is the ideas formed from society and culture that are attached to the sexes. So then I asked him, what happens when a child is born and they're assigned non-binary? So I asked him what would happen if a child was born and they were assigned the gender being non-binary.
Which, like, doesn't
happen.
And
he had nothing to say. Now, is it common? No. But there are kids that are assigned no gender or no strict box of a gender when they are
That's
born.
Good. So this when is I the
we know where she's going.
This it's is done. Who votes for Kathy Hochul.
I guess. Or she gives her ballot off to someone else and lets them run it to the box for
or
her.
Or runs a few ballots herself and knows that what we're up against is bigger than the Constitution and your voting rights. We need to do what's right because there's a hateful group trying to take power that's authoritarian and fascist.
Fascism.
And we need to fight back for our democracy. So we're willing to do anything it takes to prevent the Republicans, which is literally the mindset, which is why everyone is able to collect so many ballots and why the single unmarried women are the ones who voted stupid.
It's like a different kind of gaslighting. You're gaslighting everybody into thinking their rights and their whole livelihood is on the line. How about the like casual mention of like my students know that like if they talk about, you know, sex education, she calls it that, but it's like you're just going off on gender shit.
And they know
they know they can suck you in. Yeah.
I get sucked into their loophole.
It's like sounds like the kids are running the class and they know how to waste your time and not do math.
I was the king of that in school. And I had an English teacher who I love and she was great, but we could really get her going and talking. And then like there was one day I had like some kid who like won a karate award. I was like, Miss C, do you think it'd be a cool idea if Steven, since he won the karate award, could maybe teach some self-defense moves for the girls? And she's like, that's not a bad idea. And then it would be like 15 minutes of him like doing karate.
Yeah,
like, and we're all just like not reading, you know, Huck Finn or whatever.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's who voted for Kathy Hochul. That's who teaches the kids, doesn't know loophole.
That's who think abortion up until 9 months is a human right.
Yeah. No one should be forced to carry a baby. It's like... No, there's a lot of other things you could have done up until that point to prevent it, buddy. So, yeah, that's who votes, doesn't know loophole.
Loophole.
Just uses it like kind of how she thinks I get sucked into their loophole. It's like, that's not even close.
Get sucked into their loophole. Come on, lady.
Yeah. All right. That's the end of our cringe of the week. That was a great cringe of the week section. We are heading now
a little
into
different. A little different. A little non-traditional, which I like.
Yeah. The whole N-word take was, that's tough. Yeah. That was a tough one to pull off, but it's true. It's true. If some drunk, stupid girl in the cafeteria says something, it's a reflection on her. She's an idiot. She got too drunk. She made a bad mistake and she's foolish.
Yeah.
But that's not what's holding everyone down.
The university system springs into action, too. Like, we have safe spaces. We're offering counseling. There's a rally.
No class this week. It's like, all right. Like,
did they actually do that? Or
100%.
They did?
Okay. Sit-ins. People weren't going to class. They were protesting. And it's just like an excuse for whatever your shortcomings are around, for whatever reason you're not where you want to be, you can now say it's because this racism still exists. And we saw it here on our own campus. Now I'm not going to the midterm.
Yeah. Hey, well, I'm noticing a parallel, right? These types of people, the little kids, they get their teacher to talk about sex ed. They derail her for a little bit. They don't have to learn math or do whatever. These college kids, they don't want to do their midterms either. They don't want to write that paper.
So true.
So they cry racism and go, all right, give us a few days off.
Arrested Development, derail. Derail the authority. So it's like everyone can just be kids for longer.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that's a good point. We wrapped it up nicely there. Next section, our urban decay section.
Okay.
This is an important one. The first clip, the road rage fight. So there's a truck versus a PT Cruiser. They're going crazy.
Truck wants to pass. PT Cruiser wants to block.
They're just rushing to go vote for John Fetterman. We got to fight climate change, bro. Get out of the way. So this guy in the truck gets out, starts punching the PT Cruiser guy.
Open window, big mistake.
Which you think is smart because whoever drives a PT Cruiser is a PT loser. Yep. But... PT Cruiser guy also has nothing to lose.
He swings back. He gets out. There's a tussle.
You drive a PT Cruiser, you have nothing to lose.
PT Cruiser guy wants to get back in his car. Truck guy wants to swing again.
And then now here's the fight.
Here's
and
the
then
tussle.
Truck guy gets smoked.
Truck guy's off balance. Tossed. Ooh. Head on the concrete. Hurt.
Really
PT Cruiser guy
hurt.
Making his escape.
Green
and
light.
And he's off into the sunset around... Yep. Wow. Dash cam guy must be celebrating right now.
Like, that's good content.
I got all of this. This guy stumbles off, the truck guy.
Back into his car.
And it's
and
over.
It's over.
What are your key takeaways here?
PT Cruiser guy had nothing to lose. Mm-hmm. If you're going to get out of the car and throw the first punch, you better game it so you don't lose the fight.
Mm-hmm.
That's embarrassing.
That's humiliating.
What about you?
Nothing. Losing to a PT Cruiser, I think, is the most embarrassing part of that whole thing.
Yeah.
And then the other thing, it's like, what was the best case scenario? What was the best case scenario?
He came in and you knocked him out through the window.
And you go, I told you.
And then he's like dead in his car.
And you might still get a charge because of the dash cam. But this guy's got a damaged car now. Their car's hit.
Yeah.
The guy's got a damaged car now, and he got knocked out by a PT Cruiser guy.
Drove off.
And there's no winner. There's no winner in road rage, I think, is the main point. That's pretty obvious to the normal audience.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't let a street rat or a street rat adjacent person bait you into losing your temper and doing something irrational.
Exactly. Next thing is kind of election related. The last few weeks, Democrats have been going around because Republicans are talking about violence and how violence is up and it's super bad and it's true and it's up everywhere.
Yep.
Especially in cities. And then the Democrats are going around pretending and saying, what was the headline?
This woman tweeted, she said, other than murder, violent crime is not up. Did you know that? Violent crime is a key midterm voting issue. But what does the data say?
Oh, the data says it's down besides murder.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Other than murder.
And that's literally because the cops can't do their job anymore. They're not allowed to. Mm-hmm. No one's getting prosecuted. If you do get prosecuted, whatever you do wrong is like knocked down severely. So if you rob a store with a gun, by the time you get charged or whatever, it's like misdemeanor, whatever, a little mean. No one gets in trouble. So all these things, no one's actually getting charged for crimes. But murder, you can't really hide that stat because there's a body in the box in the morgue.
Yeah. Yeah, someone's toe-tagging him. Yeah, there's a whole thing.
So you're getting toe-tagged at the morgue. You can't really hide that stat. So besides murder, crime is down. It's like murder is the real indicator here.
Yeah.
So if murder is up, everything's up.
Yes.
And if it's not up, it's because you guys are choosing not to prosecute and to knock certain charges down. Mm-hmm. So that's how that gets explained.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's based on this. What do the stats say?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Let's trust you now as soon as you discarded
COVID
murder.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Besides murder, it's like, isn't that the one that you can kind of like put as the cornerstone of a violent crime stat?
Yeah.
If murder's up, robberies are up, carjackings are up, assaults are up.
Yeah, if someone's willing to murder, they're definitely willing to do all the little smaller stuff in between.
But yeah, crime's down. Go vote for John Fetterman.
Thank you, John Fetterman.
All right. Next, we have the stripper dump.
What?
Stripper dump.
You're doing light skin.
Light skin.
Ah.
Throw some light
in. Yeah. I think you dropped some.
I think you dropped something.
What the hell?
Yeah, crime's down, though, right?
Stripper shitting on the street. I don't know.
Crime's down, though.
Yeah.
Cities are good. Just murder's up. all right. This next guy is a pet of Richard Rapoy. Richard Rapoy and I have human pets, we call them. It's people that are like obscure and random that we like to follow and hyper focus and basically treat like their own reality show.
Yeah. People who put themselves out there on social media. Like we keep them as a pet. We're like, okay, we'll pay attention to this.
Exactly. And it's like we don't watch, you know, the Master Chef. We don't watch cartoons. We do watch our pets and treat them like TV shows.
Yes.
So we have a guy that we like. We're going to look at every story. We're going to look at all of his posts, and they become our pet and our mutual entertainment, which we both watch.
Yes.
So this guy is a big Richard Rapoy pet.
This guy,
I'll give an explanation of what he is up to.
Yeah, I got to preface this a little bit. This guy's like an ugly type of Asian guy who wears these thick glasses, and he's kind of like a middle-aged guy. He's on TikTok. He's got 20,000 followers.
Mainland China type.
Yeah, mainland China type. A little bit of a language barrier type. Drinks. He drinks. He's kind of like messed up all the time. And so what this guy does is he goes to restaurants and like not restaurants. Like he'll go to Outback or like Applebee's or like a local place like that. And he basically is filming himself the whole time. And then he always gets his credit card declined. He always gives the place a bad credit card, and then he's filming himself, and so there's inevitably a confrontation like, hey, man, your card's declined, blah, blah, blah. So let me just play.
Yeah, and he always drinks. He's always drinking like three or four beers by the time it's time to sign out.
And so he plays.
So he's a little buzzed when the confrontation happens.
So he's a little drunk, and he plays on this kind of like language barrier, drunk misunderstanding, the card's not working, and just kind of, I call it dine and dashing, just without dashing when you're ready for a confrontation. So
he just faces him.
He just, which I kind of respect.
I love it.
But it still falls in Urban Decay because he's a street rat.
That's why he's a pet.
I need another car, but it's not going through.
How much the bill?
Yeah, it's not working. It's not going through.
Oh, really? It's not going through. How much is the bill? I don't even know.
$45.77.
It's not working. Oh, as if he doesn't know.
So it's always like snippets, and he goes, how much the bill? And he kind of goes, oh. And he offers no solutions. He's just like dining and dashing in front of them. And so here's another one where the guy kind of like caught on what was happening and kind of tried to expose him. But this is honestly what his fans want. This is what I want. Yeah. I like when the confrontation gets greasier. So here's this one.
This guy, he's at a bar. He paid, but the credit card is no good.
Yeah.
No money. This guy has no money.
No money. Oh.
You have to leave. You have to leave now.
Yeah, boss. Oh, okay. My goodness.
You have no money. You have to leave.
He's only posting like a 10-second interaction, but it's like the worst, most embarrassing moment of your life. Like, could you imagine getting run out of a restaurant? Like, this guy has no money. He has to leave.
He goes, oh, the credit card was declined. He goes, oh, okay.
Dine and dashing to their face. It's like a whole new level. It's like, you know, you have a bad credit card and he's eventually going to get banned from everywhere.
Yeah.
And people are, oh, I just watched one before the show. People are kind of catching on. He's like, I got a few calls about you. You're not going to pay. So this guy's
card don't work. Okay.
So his at is only best show. Only best show. I don't even know what that means, but if you guys want to follow, so he's on TikTok and he's living in his own world.
That's the dream. Second to last clip, the payday loan.
Yeah. So this is also from TikTok advertisements. Mm. And so I had been scrolling on this and I don't know. I just found it hilarious. So
can we skip to the good part?
Getting a cash advance from Clover. And being able to go out on the weekend.
Yeah. So basically it says POV laying. They try to make advertisements memes now because they want to trick you, which I get. I get that. Smart, I'll do that. But POV laying in bed waiting for my next paycheck to hit in order to go out. And then can we skip to the good part? Get a cash advance from Clover and being able to go out. So you get a salad.
Go to a restaurant.
With your boyfriend. You go to a restaurant. You immediately go to the Bulls game.
Shit see to the Bulls game.
Even though you're broke. Yeah. Section 310. even though you're broke, and then you go to the barcade. Yeah. Because that's what we do on the weekends.
You need money. Is your brain wired for instant gratification, but you don't have $180?
Yeah.
Clover.
So that, the urban decay is obviously we have known about payday loans and being predatory, and you go to a payday loan store and you end up paying like 8,000 APR or something ridiculous.
And it's usually used to be for like buying groceries or like paying your rent, right?
Yeah, 100%. But even still, that's predatory.
Very
right?
predatory.
And like it should be your last, like you should borrow money from someone who hates you or like who is on your last straw before you go to a payday loan place. Now it's just this Gen or whatever, this Zoomer thing, which is literally borrow money and become a debt slave to go out on the weekend. Good luck.
To go to the Bulls game.
Yeah.
These people, they really value themselves. They think they deserve, you know, no need to work hard. They deserve to do all the fun things.
Yeah, I'll just get my pay now. And then it'll cost me, I'll borrow $100 for $182. And then I'll do that next week. And then I'm stuck in a time loop. And eventually my paycheck is zero.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm already in student loan debt. And then I'm already, blah, 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 living in the whatever place I get a discount for with my boyfriend. And then you have like all these like, shit things that leads to like these people becoming an entire class of serfs.
Yeah. And then they'll vote a certain way because they've been serfed.
Yeah. Because now they need to vote against the Republicans or else so they can get their student loans forgiven.
Yeah. And so we obviously don't need to tell the audience. This audience here does not take on dumb debt.
That's right.
This audience doesn't do dumb shit like that. So we're just going to make fun of it instead. Yeah.
Last piece of urban decay, that guy Takeoff, the rapper who died. We covered that last week, and you'd think there'd maybe be a reckoning, a call for accountability.
Some sort of self-reflection, like why do we put ourselves in these situations?
What's part of our culture is causing all these premature deaths in our young men?
We have to do better in our community, something like that. But
instead,
quite to the contrary, this brilliant author, Kendi King, wrote an article titled On the Passing of Takeoff and the State of Rap, How white teens have increased violence in the genre.
Yeah.
Personal accountability, listeners. Like reflection.
Or is it the white people who listen in?
Is it the white teens? And it says, following the tragic death of Migos rapper Takeoff, let's take an honest look at issues within the rap community without the racist remarks white media loves to make about the genre. So, okay.
So are we talking about the culture?
Without the racist remarks. white teenagers.
Yeah.
And so here's a paragraph from it. I mean, we're not going to say too much about this. We just thought it was hilarious. It, like, so irony. And there's a paragraph and it says, but if we must point fingers at why so many young black rappers are dying, let's point them the right way and be sure to analyze all the factors here, including the role young white men play in these highly publicized killings. So
it's like, wouldn't you point the fingers at yourself and be like, why were we gambling with people with guns who want to shoot us? And why are we rapping about killing each other? Yeah.
Why do we need hits? Why do we need to come to town and get protection from Jazz, whatever, the kingpin of Houston?
Yeah. You know,
why do we need protection when we travel?
The white teenagers might get us.
Yeah. And so the thesis of the article, I won't bore you with the details, but it was all like, they demand more violent lyrics and they demand more codeine and syrup lyrics. And it's just like, dude, I don't know, man.
I would talk to your managers and agents about that. They seem to be signing rappers that promote that. Mm-hmm. I haven't heard of, you know, there's very few rappers that promote.
No white teenager has given you a $3 million advance or forward, you know. On,
that's who's rewarding the type of content being rapped about.
Yeah.
Not the white teenagers listening to it.
Skip the label, skip the agent, skip the producers who say, oh, that sounds fire. Skip the radio who gives them airtime. Mm-hmm. Skip the Spotify executives who promote the streams or do whatever. Let's just go straight to the end consumer, white teenagers who are wearing basketball jerseys.
And that's why the black rappers, are doing crimes and murders and drugs. It's to entertain the white teenagers.
Yep. Yep.
Because if the white teenagers didn't like it, they would do something different.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, that's pretty good. And that gives us kind of like a better feeling, a more lighthearted feeling heading into Uplifting Gold this week.
Yep.
Before we get into Uplifting Gold, we have a message from our sponsor. Guys, Uplifting Gold this week is brought to you by our very good friends at Gold River Trading Company. Guys, are you a tea drinker or do you have some tea drinkers in your life? Well, why buy tea from companies that hate your guts? Why not buy tea from an America First company that supports and sponsors this show? If you're drinking tea anyway, you might as well get it from someone based. GoldRiverCo.com is the website. Use code FLECKUS for 10% off site-wide. This stuff is great. I wasn't a huge tea drinker, but now I am, and I drink the iced tea. I've tried the pumpkin spice tea. They have hot chocolate now. Holidays are coming. Get this holiday offer 10% off. Get the people in your lives that like tea some tea from people that like you back. This is an America First company. It's very important to support companies that support you, and they support free speech, and they support us. GoldRiverCo.com is the website. Use code FLECKUS for 10% off. If you send me a screenshot of a purchase from GoldRiverCo.com for over $40, I will send you a free base mug. So if you guys want to get a cool holiday gift for somebody in your life, get them some cool tea, some base tea, maybe some hot chocolate, and give them a base mug to drink it out of. It's the perfect holiday gift for yourself or someone in your life who likes this stuff. GoldRiverCo.com is the website. Use code FLECKUS for 10% off. We love Gold River. Get some tea today. It's fantastic. It's high quality. Do it now. GoldRiverCo.com. Use code FLECKUS. Cool. Thank you, Gold River. We love you. Guys, make sure you get your Gold River tea today. First clip of Uplifting Gold, the fake Pledge of Allegiance. So yeah, this is a girl who got brought to her boyfriend's house for the first time, and they had dinner with the family, and there's a little prank they played on her.
You guys ready for dinner?
Yeah.
All right.
Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands. One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
The dad's wearing a "I stand for the flag" shirt.
And the spin at the end. And no one even acknowledges it. Oh, that's so good. That's my favorite kind of bit.
Yeah, that's good stuff.
We used to do that at the old house in St. Petersburg, Florida. The first time we were all together, it was me, Rap Boy, Typical Liberal, and DC Drano. And we were watching, I think, like an NFL game, and the national anthem was playing. And then we stood up for it in the TV room.
Took off our hats.
Like, and we're not going to tell you what happened or if anyone was peer pressured into standing or not standing, but it was a pretty funny bit.
Yeah. Someone stood.
Someone stood. It was like a peer pressure social experiment, and it was a very good one.
I think the chef's kiss on that pledge video is her doing the spin afterwards, because that's inexplicable. That doesn't mean anything. You know, you should use some critical thinking as that happening.
And at that point, you got to go, all right, this is a bit, right?
Well, here's the thing. I would, if my family was doing that as a bit, which we totally would, like that's the type of thing we would do. If I would respect someone more if they called it out, like you guys are kidding, right? Like yeah. There's no flag here.
If she just goes along with it and does the spin, yeah. It's like, you guys should probably break up.
Yeah. You're kind of a follower. I don't know.
Next clip, the old woman, the grandma in the time loop. So yeah, this is a grandma who is trying to do voice to text and kind of gets stuck in a time loop.
Trying the microphone, and I hope this comes out right. Because, oh, I should say a period, right? I'm sorry. Wait a minute. Oh. Breathe deep. Okay. Oh, what does that say? Wait a minute. I'll read it. Okay. What is it? Say, wait a minute. I read it okay. Who read it okay? Is she answering me? Is she talking back to me?
No, that's you.
Is that me?
That's so good.
Oh, grandma cannot conceptualize and think outside of herself anymore.
She got stuck in a time loop and the computers are talking back.
Yep.
Next one, dog swims over other dog.
Yep.
This is uplifting. No music on this for copyright reasons. Dog's in the water. And the other dog just gets dumped.
Sure enough.
Which I like. I don't like husky dogs like that.
Yeah, little skinny guys, little skinny huskies.
Not a fan.
I actually like huskies.
They're okay.
Nothing wrong with them. Not in Florida, not in Texas, not in the South.
Yeah, they're okay. Next, Jack guy curls 125s.
Yeah, this guy's shredded. He must be a beast if he's curling 125.
He's strong AF. If you're audio only, there's just an absolute beast in the gym curling 125s. He is a savage. Look at that. Working out so important. We've been working out more, but curling 125s, it's like, it's discouraging if you see that, because then you're like, oh, I curl 40s, which I thought was a lot. 125s, that's 3x.
Do you think there's something to that? Do you think even just having, like, even without proper form, do you think holding 125 that much does something for you?
You're holding 250 pounds in your hands and you're moving it around. It's not your it is your biceps a little bit. But it's like,
it's not pure form.
It's all your grip strength muscles.
Your engagement
it's
muscles.
In here. It's like your core.
Obliques.
That's not easy. Even though it's the worst form ever and bad and not
curls.
Not
technically.
Curls. Moving that weight around definitely ain't nothing.
That ain't nothing. I agree. Okay, good. I thought you might take the opposite position, but
yeah. Next, rollerbladers wipeout. This is kind of like a lesson, you know?
Yeah, uplifting lesson.
Wiped out. Dead guy. Keeps going. Another wipeout. Dead guy keeps going.
This guy's a little more wobbly and knocked.
They never had a chance with this race.
Yeah. That guy's down too.
But everyone just gets up and keeps going, which is very important. That's the lesson of the day.
That's the uplifting part?
Yep. This next clip is actually probably the most uplifting thing. And this is where we're hoping that our audience maybe feels something again. You guys feel like maybe your brain got fried. It's not like how it used to be. You used to be able to feel things, and now you're kind of just numb in the world. Hopefully, this will inspire you and make you feel like, hey, one day we can feel again or whatever. And he's feeling good. He's got a little girlfriend. Feels good. That's what it's all about. That's America. That's what America's all about.
That's it.
That's guy stuff right there.
Yeah.
One day, maybe we all feel like something again.
Yep. And not to take away the uplifting gold, but you know what the left wants that girl to do. They want her yelling on a bridge about climate change.
Killing her babies.
They want her writing Joe Biden on her bra and doing this.
And
so.
Killing her babies so she can go get into $200,000 of student loan debt.
Perfect plan.
Yeah, the perfect plan. And then when you're in student loan debt, then we really got you. The last thing from uplifting gold, maybe the favorite thing of the week, obviously Ron DeSantis had a great win for governor of Florida. Little Ron DeSantis over here.
Huge win.
Huge win.
And he's got Junior.
And he's got little Ron DeSantis. Little Ron. There he is.
Look at him and his little suit.
Yeah.
He looks just like Ron.
He's little Ron DeSantis.
He's Ron Jr. He's little Ron DeSantis.
That's what it's all about. That is the end of our episode, end of Uplifting Gold. Thank you guys for watching. Before we sign out, we have a couple shout outs this week. Shout out to Amber Tracy's son, Brad.
Okay.
Who has been taking care of her. Amber is a big fan of the show. So is our whole family. She had a little bit of a hip injury, broke her hip.
Hip surgery.
But she's doing better. We love you, Amber Tracy. I'm hoping you're feeling better. We are praying for you. You're going to bounce back and be absolutely fine. We appreciate your viewership so much. And your son, Brad, for taking care of you is beyond appreciation. You guys are the best.
Nice work, Brad.
Also, shout out to the KGB boys. They got their Clinton shirt. I sent them some Clinton shirts this week. Here's the KGB boys. They have a great show, which will be linked in the description as well. Check them out. They have podcasts, great content, Man on the Street. These are up-and-coming guys. These guys are Chads. These guys are very based, Christ-pilled. This is the future. I love the KGB boys. Shout out to you. And then this last little clip, husband and wife watching Fluckus Talks while they're about to go into birth. This woman's about to give birth, and the last thing she does before giving birth is watch Fluckus Talks, the podcast, with her husband, which is amazing. Thank you guys for watching the Fluckus Talks, the books. Please like, share, subscribe, all the good stuff. ShopFluckus.com for the best merch in the game. Make sure you get your Undertech underwear and your Gold River Trading Company tee. Links are in the description. Remember, if you send me receipts for both of those, you guys are getting base mugs. That's amazing. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you at the next one. If you're still here right now, you're at the end of the episode. You must have watched it and liked it, or at least enough to watch it all the way through.
Or you're dead. You hit your head and there's blood seeping from your head.
Someone's coming to help.
Yeah.
We have Bonus Land coming up. We have an extra episode that comes out every Monday, about 30 minutes long. It's Bonus Land. Please join. Links are in the description. Patreon.com/Fluckus or YouTube join. We have a lot of great topics this week. It's a 30-minute episode. Comes out on Monday. So if you're still watching and you like the show, you would love Bonus Land. It supports the show. It's only $2 a month, which is 50 cents a week, which is nothing. I throw coins out now.
You're throwing coins?
I'm throwing coins. So if you guys have an extra $2, give it to me, and then I will just disperse it among my people.
You know, it used to be I only take silver. Like, I don't pick pennies up off the ground. I only take silver. Now it's turning into quarters only.
Yeah, so, quarters only, 100%. Yeah. That's how I live, too. So please join us in Bonus Land. It's a lot of fun. It supports the show. And get in before the price goes up, because right now it's $2 a month, but the price will not be $2 a month for much longer. We have over, I think, 1,400, 1,500 people in Bonus Land. Join the community. If you don't, I hate you.
I'm blowing this place up.
Yeah, I'll pull my song. All right, thank you guys for watching. We'll see you at the next one.